Their medical device is routinely used by both men and women. And as a growing number of the U.S. population ages, it's a device certain to increase in demand and use. Now, we're talking about urinary catheters. And while a sensitive medical topic, no doubt, it's one that really merits discussion. With us to do exactly that, Nikki McCormick, Managing Director for Wellspect HealthCare. Also joining us this morning is Dr. Matthew Sand, a urologist with the Shepherd Center in Atlanta. And later on, we're going to get a close-up and personal conversation with two catheter users, young adults benefiting from the use of state-of-the-art catheters, here to lend their personal perspective on this important topic. Good morning to both of you.
Good morning.
Nikki, let me start with you. Let's talk about exactly what is a urinary catheter and what it's used for.
Okay, well, intermittent catheterization is the second best way to enter your bladder. The first way is what you and I do voluntarily every day.
Sure.
It's a special tube called a catheter that's inserted into the bladder, it drains the urine, and then it's removed and discarded. So it allows the bladder to work normally, filling and emptying as needed. And there are many conditions that cause the bladder to not work properly, for instance, spinal cord injury, MS, spina bifida, the aging process. So intermittent catheterization allows the bladder to work normally. And Lofric is an hydrophilic catheter that allows the patient to use that product and maintain their bladder health.
Doctor, obviously the makeup of a man and woman are different. So are catheters designed differently for each individual?
Sure, the ultimate design of the catheter is similar. It's really the length of the catheter that's different. It's the male and female urinary tract are of different lengths. That's the main difference.
Now, Nikki, your company developed and invented the hydrophilic catheter. Tell me more about that.
Wellspect, formerly Astrotech, invented the Lofric catheter back in 1983, and we've continued to develop and evolve the products during that time up until the present day of the newer products like Lofric Arrigo and Lofric Sense. So we've been around a long time, had a lot of experience, and we continue to, after 30 years of being an expert in the intermittent catheterization market, we're leaders in innovation, quality, development, and providing educational materials for users and healthcare professionals too. So as a company, we strive to passionately make a real difference to everyone every day that uses our products. And that's important if this has to fit into your lifestyle. And so we want to continue to evolve and develop and provide a solution for our users.
And doctor, you obviously being a urologist, what's the feedback you've gotten from patients with the Lofric line?
It's been a very, very positive feedback. Many times I'll expose the patients to this TEP catheter, and they're surprised at how easy it is to pass the catheter, how smooth the catheter is, and it really does change their day-to-day life and improves it. And overall, they've been very satisfied with this type of catheter.
Which is great, because when you first think about the word and you hear the word catheter, you immediately kind of cringe, but yet there could be a difference where it doesn't have to be so painful.
Right, it's a delicate topic in general. Anything that can be done to make it easier from a day-to-day standpoint, we're always in favor of.
Nikki, something very important is health insurance and if it's covered. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, most insurance providers will cover intermittent catheters, but what's really exciting is you can have Lofric, which is a superior, clinically proven product, the most documented catheter in the world. And it's at no extra cost to your healthcare insurance. And when you're catheterizing up to 2,000 times a year, not only is bladder health important, but it's vital to keeping healthcare costs down.
And doctor, I do applaud so much patients today being their own advocates. It's really come a long way.
Yeah, there's it's very important to realize that, especially with medical products, the generic prescription, like a generic medical tablet, is not the same thing as generic medical device. And I'm always encouraging patients to be aware of what devices we're recommending and make sure they're continuing to use what we're writing for. Because it's a big difference between a generic medical device and a trade medical device.
And I'm really looking forward to speaking now with our next guest. I want to thank you so much for the
information. Thank you very much.
Doctor, thank you so much.
Thanks for
having me. Really appreciate your time. And when we return, we're going to meet two remarkable young people who've met life's challenges head on, living proof that great attitude and great technology together can and do produce great things. More when The Balancing Act returns. See you right there.
Project.
Welcome back, everyone. We're joined by two remarkable people, Ali Stroker and Jesse Balaur, so accomplished and catheter users as well. Good morning. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you.
Now, I know both of you are patient ambassadors for Wellspect. Tell me what led up to that, Ali.
I was in a car accident when I was 2 years old, which left me paralyzed from the chest down, and I have a spinal cord injury.
And you, Jesse?
I actually got hurt surfing right before turning professional.
It's just so amazing how this injury that you both endured has not stopped you. You've done so much, and I want all our viewers to know. I mean, you're an actress, you're a singer. Tell me everything you've done.
I started singing when I was 6 years old, and last year I had the opportunity to be on the Glee Project and Glee, and that really changed my life, and I really feel like I am following and achieving my dreams.
That's great. And breaking news here, because Jesse is still surfing. Jesse, I'm going to show some pictures of you and just tell me, my goodness, it's amazing that you still do this.
Yeah, you know, I grew up surfing since I was 9 years old and got sponsored when I was 12, traveled around the world. And then at 17, I ended up breaking my neck and, you know, I wanted to be a pro surfer. So instead of doing that, I started an organization called Life Rolls On, where we take people with disabilities surfing and skateboarding. We do it all over the country, in Florida, California, New Jersey, Virginia, North Carolina, New York.
Good for
and,
you.
You know, we give them an opportunity to get that independence, that freedom. And the program's called They Will Surf Again, They Will Skate Again. And, you know, it's a beautiful feeling to give back.
Fabulous. And I know you're giving back also by being a patient ambassador to Wellspect. Tell me about that and tell me about how you're very open about talking about using a catheter, and it's very important for you to do that.
Absolutely. I think it's essential to open up the conversation because there is a lot of fear and embarrassment around catheterization, and there are products out there. I use the Lofric Sense, and it's small and convenient, and I can just throw it in the front of my suitcase or in my purse, and it blends right in with my lady products, and it's really made my life a lot easier.
And Jesse, why has it made a difference for you to use this one?
I use the Hydro Kit, and for me, it's just something that has allowed me to continue doing the things that I love without having the complications of bladder infections, which I had before I used these products. So, I mean, this company's obviously changed my life, and to be able to give back to the community and let them know about it, that's really what means a lot, so they don't have to go through the bladder infections, the stay at home, not being able to do the things that they love. So,
and that's the one thing that comes to my mind when I think of catheter users. I think like, oh my gosh, the infections and the antibiotics, and it's made a difference for you too, this Lofric.
Yeah, it's made a huge, huge difference. I used to have UTIs every month.
Oh my goodness.
And on and off of antibiotics, and so switching over to Lofric really has changed that and made my life a lot easier.
All right, so what's on the agenda now? How high are the waves, Jesse?
Yeah, I think right now Fort Lauderdale is probably like 1 to 2 inches.
Oh, that's nothing for you, right?
But you know, yeah.
Piece of cake. I wouldn't even do that.
Yeah.
And fishing. You let us know when you're going to be on stage again?
Mm-hmm, yes. Absolutely.
Well, good luck to both of you. Thank you so much for being here today. You guys are such great role models. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And good luck to you as well, okay? And of course, if you want to find out more about today's topic, visit us at thebalancingact.com. That's thebalancingact.com. Or log on to Facebook / The Balancing Act fans.